And now, please allow me to introduce our special guest, the new president of the Federation, Lara Rylik.
In the Star Trek Discovery Season 4 premiere, we meet Federation President Rylik, whose interspecies heritage makes her quite unique.
President Rylik is part Cardassian, part Bajoran, and part human. A mix of three races, which you don't see very often on Star Trek.
No.
Among the many warring aliens in the Star Trek universe, the conflict between the Cardassians and Bajorans stands out. Historically, Bajor was a planet populated by enlightened and religious people.
They were architects and artists, builders and philosophers when humans were not yet standing erect.
While their neighboring planet, Cardassia, was home to a ruthless totalitarian government. In the 24th century, the Cardassians targeted Bajor for its resources.
We could have turned the world into a paradise. From the moment we arrived on Bajor, it was clear that we were the superior race.
Setting up a military presence that led to a 50-year occupation and mass genocide.
The Bajorans were a peaceful people before you came. We offered no threat to you. We could never understand why you had to be so brutal.
Considered an abomination by both Bajorans and Cardassians, hybrid children from the occupation were almost unheard of.
You're not the only Cardassian officer who kept a Bajoran mistress.
It wasn't like that. Prem and I loved each other.
The head of the occupation? In love with a Bajoran?
But the Cardassian prefect, Gul Dukat, hid his hybrid daughter, Tora Ziel, knowing she would be rejected by both societies.
I'm half Bajoran, and that means I'm an outcast back home.
Thankfully, a Bajoran resistance rose to meet this discrimination and oppression. And with the help of the Federation, Bajor began to rebuild its infrastructure, push out the Cardassians, and end their occupation once and for all. More than 800 years later, President Rylik stands tall as proof that much has changed.
We started talking about a president back in season 3, and we knew in season 4 that we wanted to introduce that president. You know, we put a lot of thought into who would this president be? What does that say about the Federation? And what does that tell us about the world that we're in? It just felt like a really interesting choice to us, given the history of the Bajorans and the Cardassians.